Granny. How you doing?
Oh, hi. How are you today?
I'm doing good. Can you, I've always known you as Granny. What, can you say your full name and how to spell it as well, please?
My full name is Christine Garner.
C-H-R-I-S-T-I-N-E?
That's the way I spell it.
G-A-R-N-E-R.
Right.
And Granny, do you remember who, start with your grandparents. Is that who you remember first? You know who they were and their names?
My grandparents was, my mother's grandparents was the name of Bud Gibson. My father's name, oh, you want the father's name?
Yes, please.
My father's name was Turner Maupin.
Okay, those are your parents, or that was your grandparents?
No, this is my father. My father's name was Turner Maupin.
Turner Murphy.
Maupin, M-O-F-E-T-T. Maupin.
M-O-F-E-T-T. Maupin, okay. Mm-hmm. And then your mom's name was?
Well, my mother's name, her name was Esther Maupin.
Esther Murphy.
S-E-S-S-I-E. M-O-F-E-T-T, the way I spell it.
And where were you born?
I was born in Ringo, Louisiana.
Ringo, Louisiana. And is that near New Orleans?
Oh, yeah. No, yeah, it's quite a way from New Orleans.
Okay, and do you know where your parents were born?
Beg your pardon?
Do you know where your parents were born?
They were born in Ringo, Louisiana.
What did they do for a living?
Well, they worked on a farm. They raised cotton, corn, peas, potatoes, all things like that. What we had to eat, we mostly had to raise it.
Do you remember living on the farm?
Well, sure, I remember living on the farm.
Do you remember your grandparents?
Yes, I remember my grandfather. I don't remember my grandmother.
Do you remember his name?
William Gibson.
William Gibson. And what was what did he do?
He's a farmer too, on a plantation.
So do they own their own?
He owned his own plantation, his own place he lived on, and that's where he did his work from, like planting different things for to have to survive.
And how come you don't remember your grandmother?
My grandmother passed before I was born.
Before you were born.
Mm-hmm.
What do you remember about your grandfather?
I just remember him being a hard-working man, you know, raising a family and make sure that, you know, everything went well on the plantation.
And he raised the same thing, peas and?
Oh, peas, corns and potatoes, cotton.
Cotton.
Mm-hmm. Peas. Everything mostly we ate, we raised it.
Was there any livestock as well, or was it just things that you grew?
Beg your pardon?
Was there any livestock? Was there any cows as well?
Oh, yeah, he owned cows and horses. He owned all of that. He had his own cows and horses. Mm-hmm.
And then he passed that down to your parents?
Beg your pardon?
He passed that down to your parents, the farm?
Oh, yeah, after he passed. Well, when my grandfather passed, my mother and her sisters and brothers, they carried on, you know, until everybody started going different directions, you know, from down there, started from going like I did when I left from there, going to different places, and they all go to the same place, but went to different places.
And your grandfather, that was from your mom's side?
That's right.
Okay, and then so, what are some memories you remember? What's your earliest recollection growing up on the farm?
What do I first remember on the farm?
Yeah,
what's
the first thing you remember growing up as a kid?
Oh, I should remember all of my family and they were working and my mother and father were working and raising different things for us to have to survive.
How were times back then? Did everyone have farms? Was everyone flourishing?
No, not everyone had farms around there, but most of them did.
And if you were a farmer, were they pretty well off, or was it more middle class? Like people that owned their own farms, did that mean that they were
my
rich?
My grandfather owned his own plantation, his own land. He owned it there.
So he was that considered rich back then?
Oh, well, not always considered rich, but still well off. Well, you didn't have to go to the white man and because that who owned everything in no place, because I come from the South, you see. But my grandfather bought his own land, and his children worked at that land and raised different things on that land. That's the way to survive.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
So when you were around there, so you said that's a few things you remember. What's one thing that you remembered as a kid growing up on the farm? Did you ride the horses? Did you farm? Did you work in the help out with the land as well?
Well, I did some work in the field, but I never was a person that my mother only had me and her. I just did it like I wanted to. I'd go in the field and work sometime, but we only, you know, pick cotton and do whatever was necessary because of what time of year it was. Because they plant around April, and they harvest it around in the fall of the year, like cotton and corn and whatever we raised that year. Then I would go out there and do it, but I never was compelled to do no hard work on it when I was on the farm.
You know what did you guys sell it? Was it sold to the cotton and the other?
Oh yeah, when it was raised, you raised your cotton and pick the cotton in the fall of the year, like September. That's when the harvest would come up with the harvest thing back in them days. And you would pick cotton and take it. They had a gin mill. You would take it and have it, or, you know, take it there and you could sell it and get paid for it.
What about the horses? Did you know how to ride a horse?
Well, sure, I know how to ride a horse and a mule too.
A mule too? People can ride mules?
Well, sure, I did. Sure, my daddy had one.
Did you go fast on a horse when you rode it?
Beg your pardon?
Did you go fast on the
horse?
Oh
no, I didn't go fast when I was riding it, but I did ride. I wouldn't let them go out of trot. You know, we call them trotting that time, just going along, not going real fast, just trotting along. That's the way we call it in update. But not real fast, but not too slow either.
How old were you when you first rode a horse or a mule?
Oh, I was about 5.
5 years old.
Yeah, my mother and father were raised. I remember things when I was 4 and 5, when I was 5 and 6 years old.
What are some other things that you remember when you were 5 and 6 years old?
I remember the field, going to the field with my dad and mother and them. When they would leave me at home in the bed, and they'd get up and go to the field. And when I got 5 and 6, when I got 6 years old, I'd get up and go over in the field where they were.
Wow! Mm-hmm. And did you go to school in Ringo as well?
Yeah, sure. I went to school there.
What was the name of your elementary school you went to?
William Chapel.
William Chapel. And back then were. Was everyone mixed together?
What you mean by that?
Like, where was it? White?
Oh, black, no Mexican? White. White and black didn't mix in them days. And the facts about it, when I came up, my father had his own plantation. We was way away from town. No white was even right around us.
Oh, there was no white people around?
Not right around here, because he owned a lot of the property where we would come up on.
Wow.
He had a big plantation.
Do you know how your grandfather was able to own all the big plantation?
No, I don't know how he owned it. When I got old enough, he already had it. I didn't ask him how he come by, but I know he had to buy it. I don't know. I really don't know. I'm not going to go into that because I don't know how he came by, but I know he had it.
So how many people lived on the plantation?
Oh, well, it was a big family. My mother had about 6 or 7 of us with her brothers and sisters.
Okay, so you had, so there were 6 and 7 brothers and sisters you had?
I don't have any.
Oh, you don't have any?
I don't have sisters and brothers.
You're only child?
Mm-hmm. I'm a mother and father only child.
But you had a lot of uncles and aunts?
Yeah, she had sisters. She had quite a few sisters and brothers.
And they all lived on the plantation as well?
Oh, yeah, they lived on the plantation. He had that who worked his land. It's probably his own children.
Okay, so can you help on a plantation? Is it one house? Is it two houses? How does that work?
Oh, no, it's more than one house. We had Uncle Blanche, SG's, There was four houses on the plantation.
Four houses. And it was divided by each family? Each brother and sister had their own house?
After he got grown, he had his wife and his family. He had one of the houses. My Uncle Blanks, he had a wife and a daughter. They had a house. And then my grandfather, he had a house. My mother and father, they had their place.
Do you remember how your mom and dad met?
I don't know that. I don't know how they met. Because they were married, and then they had me after they were married. I don't know when they met.
Now, you were talking about that there was not a lot of white people around you where you live. How big was the Ringo or the area that you lived in? How many people were around? The town, was it?
No, it wasn't a town. We was out in the country. It was a country. Country wasn't a town.
Oh, there was no town?
No, it wasn't. No, we wouldn't have been had the places for the wet crops and the things not in town. We was out in the country.
And how many people were in the country? You said about 30?
On his plantation. You talk about on his plantation around where I live.
Yes, around where you live.
Oh, boy, I can't tell you a lot of people where I came from and lived. They had their own, most of them had owned their own land anyway. But it wasn't none of my father and mother's places. They had their own places.
And the owners of those plantations were black as well?
Beg your pardon?
They were black or white owners?
What? Owner.
Yeah, the ones around the other, because your grandfather owned that one, but the surrounding plantations.
There's another family owned their own land, outside of my grandfather's plantation. There's a couple more people had it. That was Uncle Chesmore and Uncle James Adams, and all them had their own plantation. They had their own land. They owned their own property.
And how close were you? Because you said when you went to school, it was segregated. When was the first time you saw it?
It didn't have to be segregated because there wasn't anything back there where we were but us. We would all go to school. There wasn't no white living back there where I were.
Oh, there was no white people at all?
Oh, not right down, not right around us there. They were some distance, but not right there where we were.
So the elementary school you went to, how many kids were in your class, would you say?
How many what?
How many children were in your class, like kindergarten and elementary?
Oh, me and my class, I don't know. I don't even remember how many of us it were, but it's quite a few of us.
And they were all just from the surrounding area?
Oh, yeah. Everybody lived there, you know. We had different schools there, just the school we went to, but they had another school about 2 or 3 miles away, and the kids on that lived down that way, went to that school. And the people who lived near the plantation where my father lived, that's the school we went to.
And the teachers, were they white at the schools?
No, they was all, they was black, they was my race of people.
And as far as, so let's talk about, let's go from elementary to middle school. Was it the same middle school as the same as the elementary school you went to? The middle school and high school, was it the same school when growing up?
No, we didn't have a high school. We down there where we live, we didn't have a high school. When you finished the seventh grade, you had to go to Shreveport, Louisiana, to a larger town. That's where all you had to finish up your school in there.
And so is that where you went?
See, that was in a city. I wasn't in no city. I was raised in a country, in a country place.
Okay.
Well, when they graduated from the school, what was down there where we were, we had to go to Shreveport, Minden or somewhere where a larger school was, and they were teaching higher grades.
Right. Let's go back to your parents. How was your father and mother? Did they have a temper? Were they happy all the time?
Oh, well, nobody happy all the time. We had the ups and downs just like everybody else, but yet and still, they were nice people.
Did you ever get spankings growing up?
Very few, because I was always afraid of whoopings. I didn't like whoopings. I tried to do what was right, where I wouldn't get into trouble.
Okay. And so can you remember what's a funny story maybe that happened, like a couple stories when growing up with your parents? Is there anything?
Did I do what?
Like, a couple stories that stand out in your mind, because you said you remember a lot when you were a child. You remember like a certain story that happened. Anything that you can recollect, any type of story about you and your parents, maybe your mom, I don't know. Like, for me, I can remember putting my hand on the stove and burning it because my mom told me, don't do it, but go ahead and do it since I wouldn't listen. Was there anything like that where you can remember?
No. I always afraid of whooping. I was a pretty good child. I didn't do too much to get in too much trouble.
So once you got to middle school, did you go to Shreveport for?
No, after I finished my schooling, I didn't go to. I was gonna be going to the eighth grade, and when I got to the eighth grade, before I got to the eighth grade, I married. I didn't go.
Now, when is your birthday? It's one's coming up, right?
My birthday is May the 21st. I was born in 1919, May the 21st.
May 21st, 1919.
Right.
So that means you'll be 97 this year?
If I really ever see May the 21st, which a few couple more months, I would be 97 years old.
What do you want for your birthday?
Beg your pardon?
What do you want for your birthday?
I don't have anything I'm wishing for my birthday. I've had everything anybody could wish for a birthday, and now I am very happy. If I live to see it, fine. If I don't live to see it, I'm like looking for a home on high.
Now, like, let's go back to middle school. So you said when you got to seventh grade, you had to go to Shreveport. Did you go to Shreveport for school?
No, I didn't go to school in Shreveport. I stopped school down there.
No, but you said that once you got to a middle seventh grade.
When you finished the eighth grade, you're going into the eighth grade. That was how they were gonna teach down there. Uh-huh. So they went. You go to Shreveport. And they had a high CC high school there, that was the name of it, on Peabody.
And is that where you went?
No, I didn't go. That's the highest I went in school.
Oh, that's the highest you went
in school? That's the highest I went.
So after you did that, what did you do after eighth grade?
After I did eighth grade, I got married.
How old were you when you got married?
I was going to be 18 on my next birthday.
You were 18 when you got married?
I was going to be 18 on my next birthday, which is going to be that May the 21st.
Okay, let's talk about your husband. Can you tell me his name?
What?
Your husband, his name?
My husband's name?
Yes.
Edmund Garner.
Edmund Garner. And how did you guys meet?
We met at school. We went to school together and to church together, and it was a community of people. We didn't live too far apart.
Was he your same age as well?
Beg your pardon?
Was he your same age?
No.
How old was he when you got married?
He's 7 years older than I were.
Okay, and then what did he live on a farm as well?
Yes, he lived on a farm. His own people had their own places.
So when you were 18 and you got married, were you excited? Were you happy? What were your thoughts?
Oh yeah, I was happy. Sure, I was very happy.
And so when you got married, did you go live with him on his farm?
My mother had her own place and everything, and his mother had their own place, so we had a place to go.
Okay, and then from middle school to high school to 18, there was like 4 years in between. What did you do in between those 4 years?
What question had you
said? Because you said the education went up to eighth grade, and after that you got married. When you were 18, but eighth grade is 14. So in between middle school and the time you got married, what did you do in between there? There's 4 years in between. Do you remember doing anything?
After she stopped going to school.
Yeah, after you stopped going to school, before you got married, what did you do?
When I stopped going to school, I got married the next year for time for me to go back to school. From the country to Shreveport, where I was gonna go into high school, where they're gonna have a high school there.
Okay, so it was just a year difference. It wasn't that much time that went by. And then when you guys when you married Mr. Edmund Garner, and you guys started, he had his farm. When did you have your first child?
Oh, it was by the time I got married, it was about 3 years.
3 years. And how much longer were you in Louisiana before you came to Los Angeles?
I came from Los Angeles in 1947. I arrived at the Union Station downtown on the 14th day of December 1947.
And why did you and your husband decide to come to Los Angeles?
My husband was in service. He and my mother was already here working. And I had a lot of more people here working. People left from down there coming here to find jobs and was here working. And my husband got discharged from over there on Tunnel Island, San Pedro.
Wait, you said your mom moved out to Los Angeles too?
Hmm?
Your mom moved out here, you said?
Oh, my mother's here before I was.
Oh, and what about your father? Did
My father and mother wasn't together. They separated before I got grown. They separated.
They got separated.
Mm-hmm.
Did they remarry?
Each one of them remarried.
And then, so who lived on the farm while they got remarried? Because it was your mom's.
My father didn't never like the country too well. He after they separated, he moved to town, his own self, and got a job there and worked.
How old were they when you went?
Remember how old he was.
No, I mean, how old were you? I'm sorry.
How old was I when?
When they separated.
Oh, my mother and father separated when I was 6 years old when they separated.
Oh, so you were really young.
Oh, yeah, they separated and I was real young.
And then when your mom remarried, how old were you when she remarried?
When my mom remarried, I don't know. I don't got her yet. My mother got married at, but I was grown.
Are you
already grown? She wasn't going to marry and put nobody over me. I was grown. I married first.
Oh, wow. So your mom was single from the time you were six until you were grown?
Well, sure. She wasn't going to put no man over me. She wasn't going to marry nobody. It's while I was growing up.
Well, now I'm a little confused on the, so when you were six and your dad and they separated, was it you and your mom that lived on the plantation?
Yeah. We lived on my grandfather's plantation.
I see. Okay. And then what did you said your mom moved out here for jobs. What happened to that plantation? What happened to your grandfather's plantation?
What happened to it?
Yeah, because you said your mom moved out here looking for work.
Oh, my mother came out here, you know. What did you ask me now again? What did you ask me about? What did my mother do what?
Yeah, well, she moved out here, but what happened to the plantation?
My mother married again after her and my father separated. Mm-hmm.
What happened? Do you know what happened to your grandfather's plantation? Is it still there?
Oh, yeah, it's still down there.
And did your family still own it?
No. Yes, some parts of it.
Oh, some parts of your family still own it?
They still down there, some of them.
Have you, when was the last time you were there?
Last time I was at home?
Yes.
What year that we went to the family reunion, Latanya?
I think 2001.
2001, wow. Is it the same as when you were growing up?
Oh yeah, everything is the same. A lot of places, a lot of people I moved away from there, but yet and still it's the same.
Uh-huh. And then growing up, what was your interaction with was it just the two races? Was it just black and white down there? I know where you were at. It was mainly black, but the surrounding areas, there were some white people?
Oh, yeah.
And how was the relations between white people and black people over there?
Well, it wasn't bad. It wasn't too bad. Everybody knows where they should know. Everybody understood, you know, how to get along with people. I'll leave it like that. Nobody bothered anybody. Everybody minded their own business.
So you didn't see any racism growing up from white people?
Oh, there was lots of that going on.
But nothing around you?
Oh, no, nothing around me. Because I didn't have to live around them. Because my father had his own, my grandpa had his own plantation for us to live, raise whatever we had to raise. We didn't have to work on them. That's why I say that, because some people had to work on their places, but my grandpa had his own place. We didn't have to do that.
Did you feel different when you were around them growing up?
No, I didn't feel any different around them because I didn't live right up under any of them.
Right.
I didn't have to deal with them.
Do you know if any of your family members have to deal with that?
Oh, well, not really, because like I say, my my grandparents, my grandfather had his own plantation. We didn't have to work up on them like some of the people did. We didn't have to work. We was our own bosses coming up working in the way we had to work. We did it. He gave us the orders what would be need to be done. My mother and my uncles and thing. He gave them the orders what to do on the plantation. They know, and they were raised there. They know just what it takes, what time to plant, and they know everything. They know how to take care of the crops what they were raising. So he didn't have no problem.
Now let me ask you a question. When your parents separated when you were six, do you remember that when they separated?
Just like yesterday.
Were you sad? Like, what were your emotions going through your head?
Oh, well, I tell you, in them days, it didn't matter to me. I was young. It didn't make me no difference. Well, they, you know, I as much as I remember now, I wasn't sad over it.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Because for a long time before my daddy left and went to sleep, I could see him regularly anyway. So I don't remember being real sad about it. As long as I was with my mother, I was happy.
And you saw your dad a lot as well, you said?
Oh, yeah. I could see him anytime. He was always going to come around. He didn't, just because they separated, he was going to see that I was okay.
Did your dad have any more kids?
Had one son.
One son. So you had a half-brother.
Mm-hmm.
You remember your half-brother at all? He'd be
Oh,
younger.
Yes, I remember him.
Is he still?
No, he's gone. He passed away long years ago.
Did you guys stay close in touch with each other?
Oh yeah, we was good. We loved each other. Sure, we brother and sister love.
And your mom, I know. So you were already grown when she married. She didn't have any more kids, children.
No, my mother didn't. I'm my mother's only child.
Okay, let's go back to your mom moving out here. You said there were more jobs out here, but she didn't want to live on the plantation anymore.
No, everybody wanted to go somewhere where they could make more money and enjoy life better.
Okay, and then do you know what she did when she came out here for work?
No, I was working in the shipyard down there. I don't know what she was doing. Maybe she told me then, but I don't remember it now.
Do you know what year she came to Los Angeles?
I don't know. I got here in 1947. She was here a couple of years before I came, so.
And did you have any, how many children did you have when you moved out here?
I have two, just like I have right now. Them two girls, what you see here.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And then, did you work when you came out here? Because your husband was discharged from the Army?
Navy.
The Navy. And then he came out here, and then what did he do for work?
When he came out here, he did construction work for a while, and then he started working for the city.
And did you work as well, or you just stayed at home?
Oh, yeah, I did a lot of work, but I did housework, private homework.
Where did you said you first came here on the train station at Union Station?
Right.
You remember that, what that was like, the experience?
Well, sure, I do. It was kind of exciting. I had never been to California before.
Was it a lot different from Ringo, Louisiana?
Oh, sure, it was a lot of different because this was a big city. That was a small town.
Do you remember the thoughts you had as far as before you moved out here? Were you excited? Were you nervous? Were you scared?
No, I wasn't sad. What? No, I wasn't. I wasn't sad. I wasn't nervous when I came here.
You were just ready to make a change.
Hmm?
You were ready to make a change?
Yeah, my mother was already here, and I had other family members already here. I was happy. I wouldn't have left home if I hadn't, wanted to come to California.
Now, where did you first live when you moved here in 1947?
1691 West Jefferson, right between Normandy and Western.
Is that a house or apartment?
It was a house.
A house. And how long did you live there for?
I lived there 2 years.
How was the neighborhood when you moved there? Like, what was the neighborhood?
Nice neighborhood.
What kind of, was it predominantly, was it mixed races? Was it white?
People? No, not right here on West Jefferson at that time. Not right in the house where I was living. No, it was just for us. There wasn't no other race of people in the house there where I was living. Because when I come to California, places were very hard to get, especially if you had children. They didn't want you. But this lady, or had a place that she could rent out, and she didn't mind me having my two girls.
So but all you knew was it was hard for people to get a place back then.
Oh, you mean here in Los Angeles?
Yes.
We're cheering. Yes. We're cheering. The people didn't, a lot of people didn't take you when you had children.
What were the people like that were around you that lived? Were they Jewish, Polish, Italian, Mexican, and Jefferson when you got to Jefferson?
Oh, no. It wasn't too many. It was mixed race. It was mixed over there. It was different. It was mixed. It's some few people's.
It was black, white, Mexican.
Well, I don't think there was any Mexican. No Mexican right in there at that time.
There wasn't any.
No.
So it was just black and white.
Right in there where I lived in the same block. It was mostly just us, and our race of people was mostly right in that block where I was. But between Western, there was Hobart coming between there. It was some of the other people lived in that area. And there was a store right there by their own net, and there was quite a few of them in there.
And then you say there for 2 years. Do you remember those 2 years? Was it hard for your husband to find the work as a working in construction, or did he find work right away?
He found it. You know, it was just too long. And after he worked a few years in construction, he started working for the city then.
And then how come you, after 2 years, you moved to where? After 2 years living on Jefferson?
I moved to 115th Street in Watts.
And that's, is that Watts or is that Los Angeles? That city, is it still Los Angeles?
It's Los Angeles.
And why did you move?
Because I was rooming. I could get a house there for me and my children.
Okay, so you guys...
I roomed at the time when I went to West Jefferson.
Oh, okay.
Because people were hard to find, places were hard to find if you had children. But this person, it would rent to you with children.
Okay. So it was your family plus a woman that lived there.
Beg your pardon?
You said the person that rented. Okay, so you bought a house in Watts and on 100.
I didn't tell you that. I didn't buy no house in Watts. I rented all house in Watts. I bought the house here.
And how long did you live on the house on 101st and Watts?
7.5 years.
7.5 years. And how was that living there? Did you enjoy your time there?
I enjoyed myself. I had my own house.
And then you moved here after that?
No, I moved to 76th Place after that and stayed there again. I haven't got this place, and I've been in this place since then.
Okay, so after 101st and Watts, you went where?
Hmm?
After the Watts, where did you move?
76th Place, right down from that big school there. What the name of it, Tanya? Oh, she's not there anymore. Okay. But anyway, it's on 76th Place. I stayed there about a year and a half, and then this place was available. The guy was going to get rid of it, and I got this place, and I've been right here ever since.
And so what year was that when you moved here to this house on 42nd? What's the address here?
149 West 47th Street.
And then do you remember what year you were here? Was it 1957?
I moved here and on the 12th day of December 1958.
You remember the exact day?
Sure, I remember.
Wow.
Been right here ever since. When this child was talking to you now, she wasn't here when I moved here. She was born since I've been here.
Wow.
Mm-hmm. So you can see how long I've been here. Prince and all of them wasn't in existence when I moved here.
Now, how was in this neighborhood when you first moved out here?
Oh, it was a beautiful place. This neighborhood was so nice. There's only about 3 or 4 of us in here when I moved up here, in here.
3 or 4 black families?
That's right.
Who were the other families?
Now, look, I got to go and try to remember all the people's names. They lived up and down these streets.
Do you remember, what was the, because you said, was it just white?
No, they was us. It was some of our race of people. Well, I was just like that. Those were the people that lived here then.
Okay, you said there was like Jewish and Italians and...
Well, this house right direct in front of me was Jewish people.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was Italians as well.
Yeah, I don't. I guess they were. They were not. They wasn't in a bus.
And so were there gates up in 1958 here? Were there iron fences? And was it, how was the neighborhood? Was the street, was this paved?
Yes, it was paved.
Were there fences up? Like there's like a lot of these gates.
This didn't have no fence at all around it when I moved here.
No fence?
No fence.
What about the, like there's gates on the windows now. All around the neighborhood it's like that. You know how they have the gates on front of the windows so people can't get in?
You mean bars on the windows?
Bars.
Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, bars.
Well, no, they wasn't. They were, you didn't see no bars in them days, well, yeah. You didn't see no bars around windows in them days, well, yeah. But when I moved in here, there were no bars. You didn't see bars, not only here, no, you didn't see a bar like you do now.
So how was the crime back then?
The what?
Crime.
Oh, it wasn't as bad as it is now.
What was it? But what was crime back then? Was it just?
I don't know. I can't tell you exactly where it was, but it's worse now than it was then. I can tell you that much.
So were there?
I hear about more of it now than I did at that time.
Right. So there weren't really gangs or graffiti.
Oh well, I ain't gonna say there wasn't any, but it wasn't like it is now.
When do you think that started to change from 1950 after 1950?
I'm not gonna try to. I'm not gonna try and say because I see a lot of changes made, but I don't remember what years and all it was made. But the worst one I remember say after I got here was the rock was here. That's the worst one after I moved here. The worst one that I had seen yet.
The Rodney King riot.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Was that close by to here?
Beg pardon?
Was that close by the riots?
Yeah, they come boy down, down. I was nice places down here on Broadway at that time.
Wow. I didn't know it was that close to where you lived.
Well, I was standing right on the porch and look at the flame, that flame buddy going up in flame.
What did you think about that at the time?
Well, I know it was bad, and there's nothing else I could think about. It was just such a bad thing to happen to a city.
Right, that was 1992. But did that when the neighborhood started changing, did you see it or did it just feel like it happened like all at once when the neighborhood changed?
No, everything just changed all at once. Gradually changed.
And when things gradually change, does it feel? I don't know what that feels like. To me, it feels like it's not as impactful as if something changed right away. Like, when did you see? Because now the neighborhood is predominantly Mexican and Black. Correct? Is that correct?
Uh-huh.
When did the Jewish family move out and other races move out?
What you say about that?
When did other races start moving out?
I don't know. I didn't keep up with the time. I guess different times people moved, sold, put it up for sale, or sold, or moved, or things like that. But about it.
So the riots were kind of a right around your birthday? Is that about right?
Yeah, I think, well as I know when they were. It was in July, I think, when that riot was. June, July? I don't know. I don't know. Right. Huh?
No, she said the worst ones were the Rodney King ones.
Oh.
There were more riots. Oh, there were 65. There was riots too?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think it was in 1955 when the riot was. I'm not sure. Thank you, sir.
What are your, what are the names of your children?
Beg your pardon?
The names of your children.
What you say about the children?
Your the names of your daughters.
Oh, my Essie Riley, and Desi Tyson. Those were my two girls.
And then you had you have grandchildren too.
Yes, I have grandchildren. Now you know that.
Yeah, no, but other people may not know that.
You know what? I'm gonna soon bring this to a close. Okay.
All right. How many grandchildren and great grandchildren do you have? You know how many grandchildren and great grandchildren you have?
Why, sure, I know how many grandchildren I have.
How many is that?
How many grandchildren I have? I have, five.
All right, as we bring this to a close, let's just talk about like some of your thoughts. You know, you're gonna see, again, 97 in May. What are some thoughts that come across your head? Because a lot of people don't make it to 80 or 70 or 60. Or there was a NFL player died yesterday. He was 23 years old.
Who died?
Baltimore Ravens cornerback.
Oh.
He got in a motorcycle accident. Mm-hmm. A lot of people don't make it to be 97, much less a little bit, you know, younger than that. What are your thoughts on life overall? Like, as you look back, what are some things that you would tell people that maybe you didn't know before that you know now, or just some advice?
All I have to tell anybody, trust in the Heavenly Father. Say your prayers. Treat everybody right, because you have a right to do that. Don't do nothing to nobody you don't want done to yourself. Trust in the prayer, in the Heavenly Father. And if you do that, treat everybody right, trust in Him, you won't have too many problems. I haven't had too many.
How long have you trusted?
Ever since I was 15 years old, I've been on the battlefield. And I'm going to stay on there till He call me home. I'm going to treat everybody right, because you have a right to do that. And that's been my motto all the time. I'm not going to do anything to anybody I don't want done to me, because everybody have feeling like I have. I'm going to say my prayers. I'm going to treat everybody right. And that's my, you know, do that until Jesus called me home.
So you're a Christian?
All I really is. Believe in the Heavenly Father. I didn't come this far by myself. He brought me here.
You think if you didn't have that, the belief that you'd be able to be here right now?
Well, I don't know. I'm not going to say that, because it's not in my hands. I'm not the judge of that. I just know what I've been doing and what I'm going to continue to do till He called me home.
Is there anything else you'd like to add for people to know?
Beg your pardon?
Anything else you want to add?
No, not anything else I have to add. No more to you. Always say your prayers. Always look to the Heavenly Father. Don't do nothing to nobody you don't want done to you. Say your prayers every night and look to the Heavenly Father.
Thank you so much.
And you have a beautiful little girl. Be a good father.
Thank you.
Okay. They was walking around at the place. We were riding on different things, and they asked them. They kept walking around.
You got to tell him who they were. You got to say Paul. It was Edmund or...
Edmund and Doc. And they were, who asked my daddy? Wasn't it my daddy? Edmund and Doc, Dick and my dad. And Mr. Zachary.
Uh-huh.
And they was walking around there on the beach, and they would go one direction. The men would, the ladies would go another direction. So we would ride the different thing, and we went down there by the merry-go-round. We were standing there and said, well, we going to ride on the merry-go-round. They said, oh, we ain't riding on the merry-go-round, because this year ain't rough enough for us. We looking for something tougher than that. They went on riding until they got to that ferry wheel. They got on that ferry wheel, and when we got off from the merry-go-round, went right there. When we looked at them, that merry-go-round had them going way up in there, riding, riding. They were holding on like they were so afraid. But when we stood there right there till they come down, when they landed and they stepped off, oh boy, they were so scared. They had. Lord help us. They were so scared. Tell them they could hardly even talk when they got there. They were so scared. It was so funny because they said they hadn't found anything. They were tough enough for them to ride. But when they go that merry-go-round ride, it had to go. Well, I'm telling you, we laughed at them that evening. It was so funny. But it wasn't funny. They were standing kind of wiping their eyes. That wind up blowing the water out of their eyes. They had them up there so high. So that was so funny to us. So, they said they hadn't found anything that tough enough for them. But when they got on that merry-go-round, they got back down on the ground. They were glad.
I think it was a Ferris wheel, wasn't it?
Well, they had the Ferris wheel. What they were on that thing? We went on the merry-go-round.
Are you the roller coaster?
Dude, I think kind of the roller coaster, honey. That the thing would take you way around and around. Yeah, what they was on. But boy, when they hit the ground. They didn't have nothing to tell us. We ain't find nothing tough enough for us to ride on. When they went on that, they come down in, boy, they didn't have nothing else to say to us about whatever we rode on. It was so funny. We had a big laugh about that one.
Wow. Was that the funniest story? Story that you think you've heard?
No, it's been several. Yeah.
Several. Oh, that was funny though.
Yeah, it's been several.
Well, you can take your thing down to honey. I ain't gonna let him trick me. I done answered his question. He been telling me that's what he wanted me to do. And I done did it for him now.
Thank you, Granny.
You're welcome. I hope it's what you wanted.